salt needs to break down and get wet to make a brine to start melting the ice. Whereas if you apply brine with it, it's already wet and it's activated right away, and it's a lot more efficient and cost effective. We were having issues where once the tanks would get so low, and there's still probably roughly 100 gallons in the tank, anytime you went up or down any kind of a grade, it would throw an error code, it would send an air bubble through the system, and then you wouldn't be able to treat your salt at that time. You'd just be dry granular coming out rather than treated.
And that's where we came up with the idea to add an extra brine tank at a lower level on the chassis to prevent that for them, to ease some of the stress in their job of making sure the truck is putting out the adequate amount of material that they're trying to achieve.
Joel has basically been able to utilize the entire saddle tanks on the truck. They pretty much almost completely drain out into that nurse tank. And the benefit to us is we can apply brine at a higher rate then, because he can run all day without airing out.
We just put our brains together and came up with the idea, and then I got ordered up a tank that I thought would fit in the area, general area of the truck that we wanted to mount it, and just started building custom-built brackets, mounted them to the frame, and mounted the tank onto them, and then plumbed it in.
This is a pretty affordable fix that could allow them to use more brine, less downtime.
If we can get all the trucks online, working efficiently, it'll be a time savings.
And anytime we can do that and improve the way that it works out for an operator, or help their day-to-day, ultimately it improves the outcome for the city.
We're lucky we have talented people like Travis and Joel that, you know, they come up with an idea. We can do it in-house, you know, to save quite a bit of expense.
You always got to be open-minded. Everything anymore, I think you have to be open-minded about, and be always looking for the future and new ideas and trying them out. And if they don't work, back to the drawing board.
We love hearing, you know, what ideas other people have. I always look through what other grants people have gotten, and it's like, how can we do things better? You know, every city or state or whatever, they're kind of all in the same boat. So it's like, instead of each person reinventing the wheel, you know, let's collaborate.